In this video, we'll bring to you some of the most useful VS Code shortcuts. So let's get started with HTML structure. When starting an HTML file, use HTML:5 and press Enter to write the basic HTML structure. For creating HTML elements, don't write the full tags yourself. Just write the tag names, press Enter, and they will be created with the start and end tags automatically. To create specific classes or IDs, just use CSS selectors, so dot for classes and hashtags for IDs. We can also use CSS selectors to create child elements. So if we use the greater than symbol without spaces, we can add one element inside another. What's also interesting is using the multiplication symbol to create multiple elements at a time. So in this case, we use *3 to create 3 buttons at a time. If you want, you can also do it for the parent element. So let's create 2 divs with a class of CTA, and inside each of them, we add 1 button. And we can use the colon to add attributes. Speaking about attributes, some elements don't even require you to write them, like the image tag that is created with the source and the alt attributes automatically. Now moving on to actual shortcuts, let's start with CTRL-SHIFT-L to select matching texts. If you want to change a piece of text, like a class name that appears multiple times, just click on it and use CTRL-SHIFT-L to edit all of them at the same time. You can also use CTRL-F to find a specific text. So let's search for call to action, and then we can choose a text to replace. So let's go back to what we had before and click the replace all button to replace all instances. The next one is one of my favorites, CTRL-P to go to file. This is especially useful for big projects with a big folder structure. Instead of opening and closing folders to find the files you want to edit next, you can just leave the sidebar closed for a better visibility of the code and use CTRL-P instead. Then you can just type part of the names of the files you want to edit, just press Enter, and you are going to navigate through them much quicker. Next on the list is Alt arrow up and down to move blocks of code. If you want to move the price tag inside the description tag, just press Alt arrow up to move it inside and adjust the indentation. The next on the list is the Alt click to add multiple cursors. This is similar to the CTRL-SHIFT-L, but this time we don't need a matching text. We can just hold the Alt key and click different locations to add multiple cursors, and then we can just type texts that will be added to all these locations. Now another super useful one is CTRL-SHIFT-P to open the command palette. By using CTRL-SHIFT-P, you can access any command on Visual Studio Code. So for example, if you want to toggle autosave, you can just do it from the command palette instead of trying to find it through the menus. And now everything I type will be autosaved, and this is also going to work on different files. If I want to turn it off, I can just go to the command palette again and click to toggle. Another interesting thing that you can do from the command palette is creating your own shortcuts. So let's say collapsing folders is something that I use a lot. So I'm going to click the settings icon in the right side, and then I'm going to click on key binding and I'm going to set my own shortcuts. So now when I go to the sidebar, I can use my shortcut to collapse all folders. If you want to remove the shortcut, you can just use Control Backspace. Now to finalize, if you want to explore more shortcuts, you can just go to Google and type VS Code key bindings. Then click in the first search result and scroll down to keyboard shortcuts reference. Now choose your operating system and you have a PDF with all shortcuts that you can print or save it on your computer. So that was all for today. I hope you found this video useful. Don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to The Web Schools.